channel Lang and Lip. Today I have come up with a new chapter from the Book of Vistas, and that is the third level. Third level is written by Jack Finney. Jack Finney is an American writer and he is very well known for his science fictions and thrillers. His famous works are The Body Snatcher and Time and Again. This chapter deals with the harsh realities and the insecurities the people face who have lived through any of the wars. There are many works in English literature which talk about the wars, the world wars, the First World War and the Second World War, and what were the effects of those world wars on the psyche of the people. Numerous people have gone through mental disorders, psychological problems and whatnot. So we can say that the war not only kills people, but it completely devastates them mentally and socially. Before we get into the details of the chapter, please subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, don't forget to like it. The name of the chapter is the third level. Level over here means the floor. Like we say, the first floor, second floor, ground floor, likewise is the level. So we are going to talk about the third level. So where is this third level? The protagonist says that it is on the Grand Central Station of New York. The protagonist of the story is a man by the name of Charlie. He's 31 years of age and he lives in New York. He's like any other normal young man of New York. Story goes like this, that this man is going to the Grand Central Station. He reaches over there and everything looks very normal. He is wearing a long gabardine coat, shoes, hat, and he looks very much similar to the other people who are walking on that Grand Central Station. He walks and keeps on walking, and he says over there that this Grand Central Station sometimes seems to him that it is like a tree. He compares that Grand Central Station to a tree. Why so? Because every time new train gates, new ways, he says that every time when he comes over here, this Grand Central Station emerges to be something new, something bigger than what he has earlier noticed. He also says that this Grand Central Station to him is like a maze. He cannot find a way. Many times he has lost his way on the Grand Central Station. In the beginning of the story, we see him coming back from his office and he is very much in a hurry to reach his wife. His wife's name is Louisa. She is also a young woman and both of them live in New York. He does not want to go by bus because it is going to take much of time. So he goes to the Central Station, Grand Central Station, and to take a train from there to his house, which is located in the suburban areas. As Charlie wanted to take the train, so he was walking and he reached the second level. On the second level, he found that there was a hallway. That hallway was not known to him, but he thought he might have forgotten that area or something. So he kept on walking on over that hallway. In that hallway, he noticed something strange. And what was that? That there was nobody else other than Charlie walking on that hallway. That hallway was sloping downwards and it was moving and moving towards the left. He kept on walking. He did not have any other option. He thought that it might be that it is going to reach to the second level or anywhere, and then he is going to find his way. So he kept on walking on that hallway. Now, fact about the Grand Central Station is that it does only have two floors or two levels. Protagonist claims that even the president of New York Central, of Haven and Hartford will vouch or will swear on that this Grand Central Station does only have two floors or two levels. But this protagonist of ours has found something new on it, and that is the third level. So we see that because he has found something which is factually not there, so his wife took him to a psychiatrist. The psychiatrist's name was Sam Vineyard. Now, he told all this story to Sam. The actress listened to the whole story which Charlie had told him. He came to a conclusion. He said that it might be that Charlie is suffering from the insecurities of modern life. He does not like the life he is leading. He is dissatisfied and he wants to move into the times in the olden period where people used to have a cheerful and relaxing time. He said that he is in stress, and that is why his body and his mind is trying to escape from the modern world to the period where he can find solace, where he can find comfort, where he can relax himself mentally and physically. He also gives another reason to Charlie. He says that you have a hobby of stamp collection, and that also signifies that you are actually not happy with your life in the present times and you want to run away in yesteryears. Bali did not affirm to this. He said that, okay, I'm living in the modern world and it might be that I'm unhappy with my things, and that is why I have this habit of stamp collection. But this habit actually has been inherited to me, or is being transferred to me, from my grandfather. And my grandfather used to live in Galesburg, which is situated in Illinois, and he was living in the times of 1894. In those times, there was no stress. Then why did he have the habit? Now, there were certain things which Charlie has not told to his psychiatrist. And those things were that when he reached the third level, he not only noticed the people around, he realized that things were very different. And then Charlie says that when he got out of that hallway, he came into a place. Entered the third level, he noticed that there was a lot of difference between the third level and the earlier two levels. The first level and the second level were entirely different. And let me show you with the help of pictures what he saw on the third level and why he thought that it was very different from the earlier two levels. The first pic, that is pic 1, shows us the happenings and the environment at the first and the second level. As you can see, it's similar to any modern setup. The people are all dressed up in very normal style of Westerners. Now let's see the second picture, which demonstrates a similar scene witnessed by Charlie. He noticed that there were very few ticket counters and very few train gates even. He also saw that the inquiry counter is made of wood. Then he noticed the grass spittoons on the ground, which in the earlier times were used to spit by the people. He also glanced across, viewing the flickering gas lights. These lights, which you see in the picture, do not have any bulb. Instead, it is the flame, and due to the wind, it was flickering or shaking. Another thing very different was the way people were dressed. They had pocket watches, which was fashionable in the 19th century. The men had big mustaches and sideburns, which was no longer adorned by the men in the modern times. All these things which he saw on the third level made him believe that he is in the 19th century, which is still going on in the third level. He was almost definite about it, and his assumptions were confirmed when he saw a newspaper. The name of that newspaper was The World, and this paper, The World, was no more in circulation. And another thing was that the publishing date on the newspaper was 11 June 1894. So all his doubts were cleared. Charlie, knowing that he is actually in 1894 on this third level, he was extremely thrilled. And the reason behind that thrill was that he can buy the tickets for himself and for his wife and go to Galesburg and live a life which he has always wished for.
Charlie was fascinated by the life at Galesburg, where he had spent his childhood with his grandfather. The wonderful town, it was very still, with old big frame houses, huge lawns and big trees, where people had time for leisure and relaxation, very unlike the modern day cities with chaos and hustle.
Decided that I'm going to buy a ticket. He was having enough money to buy two tickets to Galesburg in Illinois. So he went to the ticket counter. Charlie asked for two tickets to Galesburg. The man who was sitting at the ticket counter was also very old-fashionedly dressed, and he said that, okay, these are your tickets and where's the money? Charlie took out some of the money from his pocket and showed it to him. These notes are the notes of the present day, and in 1894 those were not the notes which were accepted as legal currency. So Charlie got alarmed and he thought that it might be that this man is going to call the police. So he ran away from there. He went off and he thought in his mind that next time when I'll come with the currency of 1894, and then I'll surely going to buy the tickets for me and my wife. Now, as per Charlie's plan, he came back, he went to his bank and took out and withdrew all the savings he had. That was $300. He withdrew that and he went to exchange the currency, and in place of those $300, he got back only $200, because he had to pay the premium, that is the tax which was levied on the notes which belonged to 1894. So he bought those $200 and kept them in his pocket and thought whenever he's going to get to the third level, he's going to buy the tickets. We see that unfortunately, this man, Charlie, did not find the third level anytime after that when he went to the Grand Central Station. But something happened in those times. In the beginning, Louisa was not ready to believe on these stories of the third level by Charlie. And she was the only one who took him to the psychiatrist. But something very strange happened, which not only made Charlie again search for the third level, that even made his wife to search for the same. Actually, Charlie got a postcard. He had a habit of stamp collection. So it is a tradition in collection of stamps that whenever a new stamp comes into circulation, on that day the stamp collector buys that stamp, puts it on an empty envelope and then again sends the same envelope to himself. He self-addresses that envelope so that he may get the mark of the date from the post office that this was the date this stamp had come into circulation. So this is the habit of all the stamp collectors. So while our protagonist Charlie was arranging his stamps, he got an envelope which was not open, but it had something. It was not an empty envelope, it had a letter. And when he opened the letter, and that letter, the content of the letter, the man who had written that letter actually made all the difference in again finding for the third level. Now on your screens will be the letter of stamp. I'll read it and explain it to you simultaneously.
The letter of Sam says, "Charlie, I got to wishing that you were right. Then I got to believing you were right." So he says over that he wished that Charlie, whatever he's saying about third level, whatever he said about the life at Galesburg might be true. And then he says that, "Yes, I believed you were right." And Charlie, it is true. He confirms over here that, "Yes, it is true. I found the third level." He has found the third level. "I have been here now for 2 weeks." So we can see that Sam confirms that he is there at Galesburg in 1894 for the past 2 weeks. And right now, down the street at the Dailies, someone is playing a piano. So here he tells Charlie about the environment at Galesburg. He says that it is so calm and soothing that someone is playing a piano. And they are all out on the front porch singing, seeing Nellie Hope. So he also tells that there are people who are singing a folk song, and that is called Seeing Nellie Home. And I am invited over a lemonade. He also tells Charlie that he is being invited as a guest over a lemonade. And then he requests, he says, "Come on back, Charlie and Louisa. Keep looking till you find the third level." He motivates them to keep looking for the third level. And then he says, "Why you should keep looking? Because it is worth it. Believe me." So he confirms, he says, he affirms that, "Yes, life at Galesburg is so peaceful, so stress-free, so calm. So now Charlie and Louisa must come and stay at Galesburg and enjoy a peaceful, tranquil life."
That letter was addressed to Charlie's grandfather, who used to live in Galesburg. The address was of Galesburg, and the date of the stamp was 18 July 1894. So our chapter ends with the letter of Sam and with the searching of the third level by Charlie and Louisa. The chapter is actually open-ended. There is no definite conclusion given by the author. He never says that the third level was imaginary or was it really something which was factual. It is up to the reader to think about it, to draw conclusions by yourself. So it is an open-ended story. So this was the third level by me. I hope that this explanation helps you in understanding the chapter in a much better way. So keep watching my channel and don't miss on to any of your lessons. Till we meet next, happy learning and be safe.